Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Briareo Scherensky, and for today I'm going to do something a bit different from the usual because normally you don't see me modifying consoles on this channel. Today I'm gonna take this GameCube, open it and install this little thing, the GC Loader, which is an ODE or Optical Drive Emulator, a very fancy term to say that I'm gonna take the disk drive out of this console and install this thing that reads SD cards. And as a bonus, let's say, I'm gonna install this laser printed card extender. You'll see why I'm gonna use this. But I've already cleaned this GameCube. You can see it's a bit beaten up. This console is quite old. It is this console I've bought with my first ever full-time job paycheck. It wasn't quite at the console's launch in Italy, but a few months after that. Damn, I'm old. And as you can see, there is a Game Boy player already installed, so I decided to keep it inside here just to let you see what the GameCube is like for those youngsters out there that don't know. And I'll probably gonna speed up portions of this video while I unscrew things and don't talk. Also because these kind of videos about the GC Loader are a dime in a dozen, but why not taking a look at an Italian guy reminiscing how old he is while doing stuff. So this is the Game Boy player, and this is the back of the GameCube. As you can see, I have a network adapter installer, an Ethernet adapter. This is the serial port where the another GameCube expansion will go. And the GC Loader also came with the special screwdriver you need for PAL consoles. I have mine, I'm using the one included in the GC Loader, just because, no particular reasons. So this is the screw used in the GameCube, and in fact many Nintendo products. Okay, these two screws are particularly hard to come out for whatever reason. I don't really know why. This screw doesn't want to come out for whatever reason, but apparently the console does want to. Oh, here's it. And here is the GameCube. I did clean the exterior before tearing it down, but this is the faceplate with the connectors for the pads and the memory cards. Well, connectors for the memory cards are here, in fact. So, also just remove this for now. I need to remove two screws. Let's see. Some of the screws don't really want to come out. But yeah, I need to unplug the fan. All right. I did remove a cable I didn't have to. Let's plug it back in immediately. So I don't forget where it goes. The little fan assembly. And now I have to remove a lot of screws all around the back plate, here on the side, here on this side, and this side. So yeah, I'll totally speed this up. And now we are ready to remove the DVD drive and unveil the main PCB of the GameCube. Now, this goes away for a tiny bit, and we now have to remove other screws on this heat spreader. I think, or maybe emission shield, I don't really know. But anyway, these screws all around the place. And now it's time to remove the DVD drive, which is in perfect working conditions, this one, but yeah, it's one major source of noise inside the GameCube. So now we take the GC loader. Now first let's clean this up a bit. And the GC loader goes in like this. And let's put just three screws for now. But before we do that, let's dry fit this. Which should go in, considering that this is the plate. It should go in like this. So I'll just try to dry fit parts before committing to the change, just to be extra sure I'm doing everything correct. So this is the heat spreader, the heat spreader that goes like this. The game GC loader goes in like this. And yeah, I was mounting this thing on the other side. So, okay. Okay, just put the screws back in. Now I'm gonna search. Let's see if I can do this. The supports on the GC loader are a bit tighter than they should be, and this will take a while I try not to destroy anything. Let's see if I can find a support like this. So yeah, I'm gonna fast forward this part. After a bit of tries, I actually gave up on doing on completely tightening this thing to the plate, because the screws are incredibly hard and I don't want to destroy the heads. So I'm gonna install this back, just one more dry fitting. This goes like this. But I should, because okay, back to tightening screws. So after some trying to tighten screws, dry fitting, and unfruitful attempts at that, I've decided to keep the GC loader a bit loose on the plate. It is secured, and I'm gonna just put this back in and snap the thing into the connector. From what I can see, the screws do not touch any PCB, so it should be safe from any accidental discharges. And what I'm gonna do is to connect this thing inside the GC loader SD card slot, and then or in fact, it's better that if I do it the other way around. Sorry. Okay, I've tried to tighten the screws on the GC loader now that this SD mount offers a nice support, but not quite the case, unfortunately. I noticed that the data cable is pressed between one of the supports of the SD mount and the head spread and the heat spreader. I feel like the Sheriff of Nottingham in Robin Hood. I need to remove it completely. Remove PSD thing and have it pass over like this. Unfortunately, it's mounted in the opposite way, but let's put it back in. And let's use this as a protection between the mat and the mount. And yeah, let's get back to screwing once again. And yeah, this is the, let's say, new optical group of the GameCube with the SD card / GC loader down here. I don't really like this, but once it's plugged in to the mainboard, it shouldn't move that much. So, mainboard. Let's attach the heat spreader first and assembled it is. And now, yeah, the theme of this video, back to tightening screws. First the SD card, the memory card, sorry. right. Okay, snap back into place the rear IO shield. All right. And now the cover. And as you can see, the SD card extender lines up pretty nicely with the rest of the console. Time to screw the chassis back together. All right, and the case is back together. Now let's plug the Game Boy Player back in. And this is much easier to screw back. And done. So this is the power button, this is the eject. I used this thing because the GC loader should be around here in height, so you can see that it's quite a bit, around here about in height, so it's quite difficult to put SD cards back in. Plus, I have already prepared this 512 gigs memory card with all of my GameCube collection, and it's about 80 gigs. So yeah, this is the slot for the card. And there are also very handy holders on the sides. So, hopefully everything works. Let's check this thing in action. So, what you see here is the blue screen of the FrameMaster before any input is turned on. And without further ado, let's turn on the power to the GameCube. And it works, and the GameCube didn't even had the time to output its intro. We are right at the main menu of Swiss, which is an ISO loader. What you need to do essentially with the GC loader is to put an ISO on the root of an SD card and call it boot.iso, like here. In this case, I have used Swiss as a boot, and what Swiss does, it allows you to load all kind of games. And it works. I am very happy, very, very happy. So it's also my first time using Swiss, so I don't really know how to get to the here I am. Ooh, nice. You can also get to the network stuff. Okay, these are all options I'll need to check. Force video mode. No, that's not force anything right now. Okay. Okay, and yeah, I. Well, let's launch a game. What should I do? This is the Game Boy interface. It's used as a replacement for the Game Boy Player, sorry. So, Ikaruga. You see, I have a bunch of PAL and American games, but what I wanted to try is the undub to Skies of Arcadia Legends. I also need to. Yeah, let's go without a memory card. Okay. And it's loading. I am very, very happy. So I'm happy that the mod to the console works and the software for the mod works as well. And now I have no excuse not to replay Skies of Arcadia. Between all the games I have to play. Hey, Aika. Hey, Vise. And to be honest, I don't remember every name in this game. It has been quite some time since I've played it. Also, as another information, the SD cards you can use with the GC loader can be formatted FAT32, don't do that, or XFAT, which you should do because FAT32 should die a horrible, horrible death. The sooner the better. Once the intro has finished playing, I'll end the video. Because I need to check a couple of things. First, if the Game Boy interface works. Okay, it doesn't pick a memory card, of course. But yeah, this has been me modifying my GameCube, my first GameCube, because I have like five or six of those consoles. With a GC loader, I hope you have enjoyed this video and you stick around for more. The next one will be a more usual video for this channel. By the way, Briareus Kerensky, over and out.